Hi everybody, I'm Lisa Shield and this is Emotionally Naked Dating. For the last 17 years, I have been showing savvy single women how to find a guardian of their soul, and I can show you how to do this too. So today I am going to talk about sex. Everybody's favorite topic. Well, not everybody's, but most people's. All right. So this one is called, this video is called, It Can't Just Be About Sex. Right? Like that cannot be the only thing that connects men and women. And I finally figured this out after a lot of mistakes and trial and error. It finally dawned on me that having sex with men just because I didn't know what else to do or how to really connect with them or how to get them to stick around, but just having sex with men because I felt a chemical attraction was not working for me. And so one day I sat back and I thought, it's got to be about something else, right? And here's what I realized. By the time I started to figure this out, I was already 39 and so, or 38, I think. And I stopped having, I just said, I'm done. I'm taking sex out of my toolbox and I am going to figure out what else a man wants from me because it can't just be about sex. So I took it out of my toolbox and I said, I'm not sleeping with anybody until I figure this out, until I really understand men. And this set me out on a journey to really understand how to connect with men, how to love men, how to be a guardian of a man's soul. And on that journey, it was about a 2-year journey. I dated and went out on almost, on 96 first dates, almost 100 first dates before I met my husband, the love of my life, Benjamin Shield. And, we've spent the last 17 years together. For anyone who hasn't watched these videos and doesn't know, I might be the most in love woman on the face of the earth. And I don't say that because of me. I say that because I have had so many men say to me, Lisa, I've never heard a woman talk about her husband the way you talk about Benjamin. I just can't say enough wonderful things about him. And I think that when you truly love somebody, that's the way it should be. Like we should be able to say the most loving, wonderful, beautiful things about each other and to each other. Right? Like, isn't that the way it goes? So, you know, I looked around and I realized that, I was no longer at 40 or 39, the slimmest or the youngest or the prettiest or the fittest woman in any room. that time had come and gone. But even more than that, I never really was comfortable with men. And, so I defaulted to sex and I decided that there had to be a way to become a superior woman because let's face it, if all it was about was, you know, youth and beauty and who was the richest or the smartest, all the celebrities would have the best relationships. And we know that that isn't true. We know that they go through as much trauma and divorce and Victoria's Secret models don't have it any easier than you and me. They may get more male attention, but it doesn't mean that they get the right male attention. So I wanted to understand what it really was about. And the beautiful thing is that I learned that to truly experience love, I had to become a more open-hearted and loving woman. I had to start to open myself up and put myself out into the world and allow myself to be seen. And I had to find my voice, right? I had to find my own true, authentic voice with men and, you know, in my life as well. And so that's what dating was about for me. It was this exciting journey to start to open up to really learning how to love and accept men, how to be a fabulous woman, and how to let go of my separate self, my separation, the ways that I separate myself from people and from men, the way I held myself apart. And this speaks straight to the heart of vulnerability, or what I call emotional nakedness. So it was about learning how to open myself up, and that's what dating gave me the opportunity to do. I knew that with each date and each experience, every time I didn't self-abandon or go into blaming myself or beating myself up if I got ghosted or something didn't work or it wasn't a match, every time I could walk through that with, you know, and love myself in the process and wish the other person well and not hold on to anything, any expectations, or feel that this person owed me anything, right? Not take anything personally. Thank you, Don Miguel. And I it gave me this opportunity to become a woman, the woman that I'm so proud of today. So this is the work I do with my clients. I teach them how to get out of their own way and open up their hearts and find their voice and learn how to ask for what they want in a strong and clear and feminine way and get everything they're looking for in a partner. And they learn how to share their head before they share their bed and get emotionally naked before they get physically naked. So it is a beautiful process. It is fun and it is hard. It is liberating and joyful. And, the women that work I have a group, and the women that work together in this group, there is a beautiful sisterhood that is formed. And it really is a magical process, so that you don't, you know, not only are you transforming yourself, but you're not doing it alone. You're doing it with the love and support and modeling of a sensational group of women just like you. So that's how this is done. You are going to come, you're going to go to my website, lisashield.com. You're going to watch my free 45-minute webinar. You are going to love it. You're going to be so glad you got to hang out with me for another 45 minutes. And you are going to watch that webinar, and then you will sign up at the end of the webinar to jump on a breakthrough call with me. And on that call, I will tell you everything you need to know about how I can help you learn to open yourself up, get emotionally naked, and attract the guardian of your soul. Thank you again. I'm Lisa Shield. This has been Emotionally Naked Dating, and I look forward to speaking with each and every one of you.